Welcome today for the home of the final game of the year for Contra Costa College. They'll be playing San Jose City College. This game will feature Contra Costa College, who's currently 5-0 in the conference, and San Jose City is 2-3. Last game for Contra Costa, they beat Mendocino College at Mendocino 62-6. The importance of this game today is this could be the first time that Contra Costa has wrapped up the conference title. So Contra Costa is coming out today with an opportunity to win the conference title against San Jose City College. So this is going to be an excellent football game for both teams. San Jose City College is coming in 2-3 in conference, a 3-6 record overall. Contra Costa College is coming in 5-0 in season and an 8-1 record overall. Captains are headed out to the field for the flip of the coin. Contra Costa be wearing their dark blue uniforms with their North Carolina colored numbers, and San Jose City College will be wearing white with the purple. Captains are on the field. Referees are explaining the particulars for the game. So in this particular game here, again, Contra Costa has an opportunity to wrap up the conference title and play the bowl game against the winner of the Southern Conference. It looks as though Contra Costa won the toss, but they deferred to San Jose City College, so they'll receive the kick in the start of the second half. San Jose City College makes their way out onto the field. So a lot of these sophomores, this is their last opportunity to play Contra Costa City College, so I'm sure they're going to come out with a lot of energy today. Had a chance to talk to Coach Carter prior to the day, and one of the emphases he was explaining that he needs to keep this team focused today because on paper, obviously, they are a better team, but so now we're going to have the singing of the national anthem.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. In the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free?
So you have a very spiritual national anthem. Teams are ready to play football.
Again,
Contra Costa won the toss, but they deferred to San Jose City College. San Jose City College will be going left to right.
Contra Costa College Comets.
Contra Costa will be on defense, where they boast one of the best defenses in the conference. They're top 10 in four categories on defense. Had a chance to talk to Coach Connor before the game, the head coach for San Jose City College, and a couple of things he talked about was the athleticism that City College of Contra Costa do possess on the defensive side. He talked about their back end. They're extremely athletic, very gifted back there. One of the things that he spoke about was maintaining the ball and not turning the ball over. You don't want to give Contra Costa a short field to play with. On the other hand, Contra Costa, speaking on behalf of Coach Carter in regards to San Jose City College, he indicated that they have a very gifted receiver. That is San Jose City College. And an extremely active defense as well on the back end. The freshman receiver is Nick Enick. He wears number 18. He's a 6-foot freshman out of San Jose for San Jose City College. So the opening kick is about to happen, and we're underway. Ball's received at the 10-yard line. He's going to the left side. Cuts back. Up in the middle of the field. He's got one man to beat. Looks like he's going to go all the way. He's going to be tackled at the 33-yard line. An excellent opening kickoff for San Jose City College. And this is one of the things that Coach Carter talked about, that he doesn't want his team to come out lackadaisical. That was an excellent kickoff return for San Jose City College. So they start the field in Contra Costa's territory. It's a 52-yard kick return. City College of San Jose is back in their offense. First pass down the field is going to be out of bounds. So the quarterback, Trenton Pagnini, went after Nick Enick, who we spoke about earlier as one of the key factors for San Jose City College, and they went right after him early in the ball game. So it'll be second down for San Jose City College. At the 32-yard line of Contra Costa. Second and 10. Pagnini back in the shotgun. Second pass attempt out to number 18. Slips a tackle. So that'll be a first down for Nick Enick. So again, Coach Connor talked about getting out and getting the ball in 18's hand, and Coach Carter talked about he's a playmaker, so I'm sure they're going to have to address him on the offensive end. There's been two pass plays, and they directed both of them to Nick Enick. So it'll be first down and 10 at the 11-yard line of Contra Costa. Trenton Pagnini in the shotgun with a single back pistol. Sends a man in motion. Fakes the fly sweep, hand off to number 20 off the left side. Looks like that's going to be a gain of 5.
20, Joseph Valenzuela.
So Valenzuela was another one of the players that Coach Carter talked about and Coach Connor spoke of as well as coming on late in the season. So that was a gain of 6, so it'll be 2nd and 4.
To the Comet 5.
At the Contra Costa 5-yard line. So it's 2nd and 5. And already, City College of San Jose has came out with a lot of energy. Contra Costa needs to figure out what they're doing on defense because San Jose City has an opportunity to go ahead and score early in the ball game. Pagnini back to pass a slant over the middle again to Nick Enick. The ball was low.
Trent Pagnini, the quarterback out of Willow Glen.
So Pagnini with an incomplete pass to Enick. It'll be third down and 4.
He's third and 4 at the 5.
At the 5-yard line for San Jose City College. This is a key possession right now for San Jose City College. I'm sure they want to come away with a touchdown. Get an early start on Contra Costa College.
Third and 4.
Pagnini in the shotgun makes the handoff to number 20, Valenzuela again. It's going to be close to a first down. Looks like he's down at the 2-yard line, so that's going to be close to a first down. They may have to come out and measure this.
Making the stop for Contra Costa, number 8, Terrence Alexander.
So it's going to be fourth down.
Fourth down, like 1 yard to go at the
fourth
comic
and
two.
One. So it's fourth and one at the Contra Costa 2 yard line.
Fourth and one.
It's a handoff to Valenzuela again. Looks like he's going to be stopped short of the touchdown, so it's going to be down. So already Contra Costa College made a stand defensively. So Contra Costa will get the ball on downs.
Turn the ball over on downs.
At the 3 yard line of, at their own 3 yard line. Big play on that
the first
drive
for
San Jose City College with a 55 yard kickoff return, but Contra Costa employed the bend don't break defense and was able to stop San Jose City College from getting into the end zone. So it'll be first and 10 at the 3 yard line. At their own 2 yard line, I'm sorry. And this is where Contra Costa, who features one, probably the MVP of the year, Jonathan Banks, will be over the center. He's had a tremendous year so far this season.
Quarterback Jonathan Banks.
Banks makes the handoff to number 28 over the right side, breaks a tackle. Looks like it's going
to
be a first down run
to Holcomb.
Carries
the ball up around the 13 and 14.
So it looks like it's a gain of
seven.
13 for Holcomb. So Harold Holcomb, a sophomore out of McClyman's High School.
Gain of almost 10, not quite. It'd be
so it'll be second and one,
and
at the 12-yard line for Contra Costa. Pitch out, fumbled by Holcomb. It's going to look like it's going to be recovered by San Jose City College. So a pitch to Holcomb.
And San Jose City
didn't get it clean, so you have
recovered,
one turnover for San Jose City College. So they turned the ball over, pitch out to Holcomb, wasn't able to handle it cleanly, and that was a turnover.
Jaguars at the Comet 9, first and goal at
so
the 9.
So it'll be first and goal at the 9 for San Jose City College. So again, they've been playing this early start of the half on Contra Costa side of the football. So a timeout against, so San Jose City College calls a timeout.
First timeout.
So it's their first timeout in the first quarter. They have two remaining. So already you see a turnover by Contra Costa on their own 9 yard line. So San Jose City College has the ball at the Contra Costa 10-yard line, so it'll be first and 10. And again, this is an opportunity where Contra Costa needs to come out and play with a lot of energy. I mean, these one of these trap games that we talked about, me and Coach Carter talked about, they have to come out with a lot of energy. They have to play the game on paper. They're 5-0. And San Jose City College is 2-3. So on paper, Contra Costa clearly is the better team, but that's why you play the game. So far, San Jose City College has been much more focused than Contra Costa. So you're going to have first and 10 at the 10-yard line. Two wide receivers set, a 2x2 with one back. Pagnini in his shotgun takes a snap, throws a fade into the end zone. It's going to be out of bounds. Again, they're targeting Enoch again. They've had three passes so far, and all three has been to Enoch.
Back on the coverage for Contra Costa, number 5, Levon Washington.
So it'll be second down and 10 at the 10-yard line.
Second and goal
for San Jose City College. Again, Contra Costa is going to have to come up with a big stop on the defensive end. Pagnini in the shotgun, takes a snap, throws a slant inside again to Enoch.
Intended for Enoch.
So that's four targets to Enoch. So far, obviously, he is Trenton's Pagnini's favorite receiver, freshman Enoch out of San Jose, California. So it'll be third and 10
29 on the coverage for
for San Jose City College.
Third goal at the 10.
San Jose City College has to come away with some points here. They've been down in the red zone for Contra Costa two consecutive series. So three receivers to his right, to his left. Back to pass. Pagnini throws it into the end zone, throws it away, so it'll be fourth down. And looks as though they're going to...
Paganini.
Looks like they're going to go for a field goal here.
So it'll be fourth down.
So number 47 for San Jose City College will be attempting a field goal. It'll be Robert Bowles.
They'll attempt a 27-yard field goal.
Attempt a 27-yard field goal to take the early lead. Here's the snap. Here's the kick.
Kick is up.
The kick is good.
It's good.
So San Jose City College was able to come away with some points from that turnover. So it's 3-0 at the 11:35 mark for San Jose City College. So two possessions for San Jose City College. They had a turnover on downs, Contra Costa's 2-yard line. They recovered a fumble at the 10 on a missed handoff to pitch to Holcomb from Banks to Holcomb. They recovered that at the 10. Three plays, gained no yards, and attempted a field goal, and they were able to get the field goal. So it'll be 3-0 for San Jose City College. Contra Costa will receive the kick at the 11:35 mark. And I'm sure that Coach Carter isn't happy the way his team is looking right now. But again, Contra Costa has an opportunity to do something that hasn't been done, is to win the conference outright. So you see the coaches down there talking to the players, trying to get them focused. So we'll see what happens on this next drive. Kickoff from Bowles. Ball received at the 1-yard line, up the left side of the field. Cuts it up, cuts right, missed the tackle. Down at the 39-yard line of Contra Costa.
37-yard
return by LaVon Washington.
Now the ball will be placed.
So this is the opportunity for Contra Costa to come out and get some points on the board and establish themselves. It's 3-0. San Jose City College is winning at the 11:29 mark. Contra Costa comes back on the field. I'm sure they're going to try to establish themselves at this point in the game.
First and 10 for Contra Costa at the Comets 37.
Three wide receivers to Banks' right and one to his left. Holcomb is a solo back. Fakes the handoff. Banks is back to pass. Eludes the rush. Takes it up the left sideline. Cuts it back upfield. And will be tackled. Like it's a gain of close to 10, so.
Santa Teresa.
It's going to be first down, so Banks with a first down run on the keeper for 10 yards. So it'll be first and 10 for Contra Costa at Shasta's.
It is a first down. 48-yard line.
Banks back to pass. Fakes the hands it off to Holcomb. Holcomb's on the right side. And looks like he's going to gain a first down on that. So that looks like that's about a 6 or 7 yard gain. So Contra Costa has a lot of weapons. They have Banks as a running quarterback and also pass. They have Holcomb, fine running back.
With second and four,
Holcomb with a gain of 6 yards. Three receivers to his right, one to his left. Holcomb is to his left. Receives a handoff of Banks. Like he's going to be short coming up on third down. So it'll be third down in a couple for Contra Costa College. It's very important that Contra Costa gets a score here to establish themselves. So it's third and two, and I'm sure Banks have an opportunity to run, use his legs for a first down as well. Checking into the game and running back is Devin Jones, number 37.
Third and three at the 46.
For Contra Costa, it's third and three at the 46-yard line. Three receivers to his right, one to his left. Banks back to pass, throws a short out. First down to number nine, Terrence Barnes.
Terrence Barnes
catches the first down. So a short out route from
Terrence Barnes on the reception.
Banks for a first down.
First down for Contra Costa at the Jaguar 40.
So it's at the Jaguar 40, maybe first and 10 for Contra Costa at the 9:52 mark in the game. Banks in the shotgun. Receives a snap, back to pass, looks downfield, is being chased out of the pocket and sacked.
Sacked, so we have a penalty flag also.
So Banks was flushed out of the pocket and was sacked by Christian Palaniti, 6'2", freshman out of San Jose, California. It was a flag on the play, so let's see what the flag says. So if the play holds, that's a loss of around 9 or 10. It looks as though it's against Contra Costa the way
Contra Costa. On the offense, number 55. That penalty's declined.
So it was a hold on the offense by number 55 for Contra Costa. San Jose City declines the penalty.
So it was a 9-yard loss on the sack.
So it's second down.
Second and 19.
Second and 19 now for Contra Costa. Banks is checking with the offensive coordinator for the next play. He's back over center. Three receivers to his left, two to his right. The shotgun. Receives a snap, back to pass. Looks downfield, is being chased out of the pocket. Escapes to his right, has running room, uses legs. Picks up pretty much the
36-yard line.
Yards that he lost. So it's going to be third down.
On the stop, 42.
Or Contra Costa counters. That's the thing about Banks. When you get him on the move, he can use his legs to get a first down or get out of trouble. And he did a good job there. Looks as though San Jose City College did a good job of flushing him out of the pocket, but he was able to gain 12 yards by eluding the first defender. So it'll be third down and 7 at the 37-yard line of San Jose City College. Banks in the shotgun. Here's the blitz by San Jose City College. Banks throws down the field. It's caught by number 80.
Yeah, number 80 of Contra Costa.
For Contra Costa. And that's Sterling Taylor, freshman out of Morrow, Georgia.
5'10", wide receiver out of Berkeley.
So it looks like that's the first down.
Holcomb on the carry.
Holcomb on the carry, so it'll be second down for Contra Costa College. Second and 9.
Gain of 1.
1-yard gain for Holcomb on the right side. Handoff from Jonathan Banks. San Jose City College has been bringing a lot of pressure today on Banks to flush him out of the pocket. But he's been able to elude a few of the tacklers and use his legs. Looks like they're going to come with a blitz again. Banks backs out, checks into a different offensive set. Receives a snap, here's the blitz from San Jose City. It was deflected at the line of scrimmage. So it was deflected at the line of scrimmage by number 52 for San Jose City College, and that would be Vincent Gonzalez got his hand up and tipped the ball at the line of scrimmage. So it'll be third and 9.
Third and 9 at the
28-yard line for Contra Costa.
Third and 9.
Down 3-0 and 7:35 in the first quarter. It's a handoff, it's a blitz, and he's stifled and tumbled down. Okay, that's going to be a loss.
99.
So San Jose City College used a run blitz. Plugged up the holes, and Holcomb lost a couple. So he lost 5, so it'll be 4th and 14.
Fourth and 14
Banks back to pass, looks over. He's being chased out of pocket, Like he's going to be tackled. No, he gets away from that. And he's sacked for a loss.
Sacked back at the 40 is Banks.
So Banks is sacked for a loss, and it's also a penalty on the play. But it looks as though it may be a holding on Contra Costa. I'm sure San Jose City College will decline that. Number 58 was called for the hold for Contra Costa. So it's a turnover on downs for Contra Costa College, and San Jose City College will be taking over the ball. First and 10 at the 39-yard line. First quarter, the 6:49 mark. Contra Costa is down 3-0 to San Jose City College. San Jose City College is back on the field with their offense. Pagnini's in the shotgun in the pistol position. They've been driving the balls thus far. He's been targeting Innick. Makes the handoff, and he looks like he's going to be stopped by number 42 on the defense for Contra Costa. Looks like that's going to be a loss. So number 42 with the stop.
Number 42.
So it'll be second down. Second down and 12 for San Jose City College. So I think it's a loss of two. Quarterback's in the shotgun. Looked like it's a legal motion on number eight. Didn't come set for San Jose City College, so that'll push them back a few more yards.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, number eight, 5 yards, remaining, second down.
The false start penalty moves.
So that's the first penalty of the day for San Jose City College.
Second and 15.
So it'll be second and 15 at the 34-yard line of San Jose City College. Snap, throw down the field again at number 18, Innick.
Pass incomplete, intended for Enna.
So that's the fifth time they've thrown to Innick's way. So that was an incomplete pass. So it's third and 15 now for San Jose City College. This is an opportunity for Contra Costa to play the field position game. They get a stop here, have City College to San Jose City College to punt the ball. They have an opportunity to make the tilt the field. So back to pass, throw over the middle. Incomplete pass. It was thrown to number 20 for San Jose City College. That's Joseph Valenzuela. So it'll be fourth down for San Jose City College. So far, they're 0-2 on third down conversions. And in football, you want to make sure that you can win the third down conversions. You want to make sure your offense stays on the field. So, San Jose City College punting. Back deep for Contra Costa be Terrence Barnes, and it'll be a timeout for Contra Costa. So at the 5:57 mark in the football game, Contra Costa is down 3-0.
San Jose City College
has been doing an excellent job of getting pressure on Jonathan Banks. And San Jose City College has had opportunities in this game. They returned their opening kickoff 55 yards and was turned away at fourth and one at the 2-yard line of Contra Costa College. And then they recovered a fumble on the next possession for Contra Costa, and they was able to convert that fumble into points of three. Back deep for Contra Costa will be number nine and number three. Number nine is Terrence Barnes, and Jeremiah Rainey are return men to receive the punt from San Jose City College. So 5:57 left in the first quarter, 3-0 San Jose City College. Here's the punt, almost a block.
Away by 92.
Contra Costa moves away from the football. Looks like it's going to be down at the 37-yard line.
37
for Contra Costa. So it'll be first and 10.
29-yard punt.
37-yard line, a 39-yard punt. Contra Costa will be taking over the 37-yard line. Down 3-0. So Banks will be over the shotgun. Two receivers to his left, one to his right. Holcomb is his lone back in the pistol. Banks receives a snap. Hands the ball off to Holcomb going to the right side. He cuts back to left. Looks like it's going to be a hold on Contra Costa.
Penalty flag thrown around the 42-yard line.
So, a nice gain by Holcomb going over the right side, but a flag on the play in the way Contra Costa is moving back.
On the offense, number 75,
so
against spot.
Contra Costa. So, it'll be a 10-yard penalty.
The holding penalty will move the ball back 10 yards from the point of the foul, and we'll put it on the 30.
So, it'll be on the 30-yard line, so it'll be first down and 17 now for Contra Costa. The first penalty of the game accepted by
first down at the 30.
San Jose City College. So Banks in the shotgun. City College fakes the blitz, drop back in coverage, downfield throw. Great catch by number 89, but he's out of bounds. That's a great catch by number 89 for City College. A fade drop down the left sideline. 89 with a tremendous catch. That'd be Jermichael Torres, but he was out of bounds on the play. So a second down and 17 at the 30-yard line. Contra Costa tried to go vertical on that play. He had single coverage on the outside. Better throw. He probably had a touchdown, but the ball sailed out of bounds. Banks in the shotgun receives a kick like it's a screen, a fake screen. Banks up the middle, slips and falls, but they fake the bubble screen to the receiver. Banks took off up the middle. Looked like he regained the yards lost on the penalty. So to be third down and 11. So far they're 1-for-2 on third downs at this point in the game. So it'll be third and 11 at the 36-yard line. Banks back to pass, throws the ball outside over the head of number 17. Incomplete pass to Renard McPhee. A flag on the play, so let's see what this flag all about. Maybe roughing the passer. If it is roughing the passer, that will give them automatic first down. Contra Costa staying on the field, so it looks like that's what it may be.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, number 28 in the defense.
So roughing the passer.
First down. Incomplete pass. First down. Roughing the passer.
So that negates the defense on San Jose City College, and it's going to be first down and 10 at the 49-yard line of San Jose City College. Banks over center. Actually, he's in the shotgun. Three receivers to his left. Snap to him. Fakes the bubble screen. Throws downfield. Slant route to number 14. Caught by 14. Cuts right. He's going to the right side. Breaks a tackle. And he's down at the 30-yard line. So a great play design by Contra Costa. Pass to Devin Jones for a first down. So it's first and 10. At the 31-yard line.
The first down at the Jaguar 31.
So great play design. So it looks as though Contra Costa is trying to take advantage of that personal foul penalty. Now they're at first and 10 at the 31-yard line of San Jose City College. Banks back to pass, throws down the left sideline again, overthrows his receiver, number 14,
Raquan
Jones. So it looks as though Contra Costa is targeting the right cornerback for San Jose City College. They've made their throws to his side of the field. So it's second down and 10 at the 31-yard line. It's 4:23 left in the first quarter. City College of San Jose is winning 3-0 against Contra Costa. Remember, Contra Costa is coming into the game 5-0. San Jose City College is 2-3. A sluggish start so far for Contra Costa. Banks back to pass. Sees a snap, throws down the field. Wide open in the end zone. It'll be a touchdown. Touchdown for Contra Costa College, number 17, Renard McPhee with the touchdown. Looked like it was a blown coverage because McPhee was wide open and Banks hit him in stride for a touchdown. Fonseca's on now for the extra point. With a successful extra point, Contra Costa will take the lead 7-0. And the kick is good, so it's 7-0, 7-3. Contra Costa College at the 4:18 mark. So Contra Costa College was able to take advantage of the penalty, the roughing the passer penalty by San Jose City College. And they went down and scored. Prior to that, Contra Costa has been stifled offensively, but the penalty by San Jose City College gave Contra Costa extra life, and Banks promptly went down and scored. So it's a 7-3 ball game now for Contra Costa College. So when I spoke to Coach Carter earlier, one of the things that he spoke about was he wanted to come out with a quick start against City College of San Jose. So Fonseca lining up for the kick for Contra Costa College. So Contra Costa College went down to score. So it's a 7-3 game at the 4:18 mark in the first quarter. Fonseca with a nice kick received by City College on the left side. Breaks the tackle, coming up the right sideline. Cuts it back. One man to beat, out of bounds. So San Jose City College's best offense right now is their kicking game. This is the second kickoff return that they've ran for positive yards. The first one they ran for 55 yards, and this one I would imagine is close to 45 yards. So City College of San Jose will start on Contra Costa's 40-yard line. It'll be first and 10 at the 40-yard line for San Jose City College. Back to pass and flare to the left side, but received by 22. Looks like that's a gain of 6 or 7. So, number 22, Jawan Etheridge with the gain. He's a freshman with a gain of 7 on the play on the flare pass from the quarterback. So it'll be 2nd and 3. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Receivers to the left of the quarterback who receives a snap in the shotgun, steps up in the pocket, throws the ball away. There was no one in the area, but he was out of the tackle box. So that's not a roughing the passer because he's clearly out of the tackle box. But there wasn't a receiver in play. But once you're out of the tackle box, if you throw the ball out of bounds, it's not considered roughing. It's not considered grounding. So it's third down for City College of San Jose. So far, in their third downs, they're 0-for-1.
Third and 3,
receives a snap and a shotgun, throws it over the middle, dropped. So the pass was on target, but it was dropped by number 22, which would have been a first down. So Jawan Etheridge dropped a first down pass. So it's 4th and 3.
Let's go
defense, hold on defense.
So right now, City College of San Jose is 0-for-3 on third downs. They're 0-for-1 on fourth downs. It's going to be a 4th and 3. Two receivers to the left and right, single back. Receives a snap, throws the ball downfield. It's going to be caught for a touchdown. A fade route to number 18, Nick Enick. Results in a touchdown. He throws the ball up for grabs, and Enick makes an outstanding catch, catches it on stride, and heads into the end zone for a touchdown. So, Enick has made his presence felt here today. They've targeted him 7 or 8 times so far, and now is a touchdown. So on fourth down, San Jose City College converts on a touchdown, pending the extra point.
Kick is up.
It's 10-7.
3:22 left.
City College of San Jose at 3:22 left in the first quarter. So on the fourth down, confidence, Coach Connors must have had a lot of confidence in his quarterback because he hit Enick on a fade route down the left sideline. He jumped over the defensive back, caught it in stride, and ran into the end zone for a touchdown. So it's 10-7. San Jose City College is winning. That's why I was saying earlier, that's why you play the game. If you look at the records coming in, in conference anyway, San Jose City College came in 2-3. Contra Costa came in 5-0. And the way it looks right now, City College of San Jose is outplaying Contra Costa in this early part of the game. So it's a 10-7 game. Back to receive is number 5.
We hope to have more combat action next week.
Number 3 for Contra Costa.
Check your left hand return.
Going right to left. Kick off. It's a fair kick. Looks like it's going to be received by number 5.
Hit the sideline.
Hits the sideline. Steps up. Tackled at the 33-yard line.
Around Washington on the return.
So Washington on return. Knocked down to the 33-yard line, so it'll be first and 10.
Either the 31 or 32 they have played.
For Contra Costa College, who's down 10-7.
Plays, Contra Costa had scored Barnett, 31-yard pass from Banks on second kick at 4:18 left in the first quarter, made it 7-3.
So I'm sure Contra Costa, if they haven't woken up, they're waking up right now because they're down 10-7. So this is an important game for them. They have an opportunity to do something they've never done, is win the conference in the North Division since they did the realignment. Banks back in the shotgun. Receivers 3 to his right. Fade right out to his running back, number 18, who's tackled. Looks like it's a no gain. So Banks pass to Dominic Barnett.
Freshman 19, Malcolm Hale.
Looked like it's a gain of short a half reception. Yard.
And actually no gain on the play.
So it'll be second down for Contra Costa College at their own 31-yard line with 2:48 left in the game, in the first quarter, I'm sorry. Banks has 3 receivers to his right. Holcomb moves to his left. San Jose City look like they're going to be bringing a blitz. Banks back to pass. Banks is flushed out of pocket. Makes a move. Cuts up the field. What an athletic move. He made nothing, something out of nothing there because he was dead to right in the backfield, but made a couple of people miss. Was able to gain a few yards, so he turned a loss into a gain. So it's going to be 3rd and 6 at their own 35-yard line. Currently, right now, Contra Costa, they're 1-for-2 on third down conversions. So it's 3rd and 6 at the 35-yard line. Banks in the shotgun, receives a snap, back to pass. A blitz is coming to the left side, like a screen pass. Makes one man miss, makes a couple of men miss. Excellent run by number 24 as he made a couple of men miss to get the first down. Excellent job of running by Wallace Payton. That was 3rd and 6, a screen pass. He made a couple of men miss and converted for the first down. 1st and 10 at their own 45-yard line. Banks hands off again to Wallace. Looks like he's going to have a gain of a couple. He's stopped over the right side.
Push back around the line of scrimmage by 10, Deion Johns, linebacker out of Oak Grove.
So a gain of 1 on the play. It's 2nd down. And 10 at the 45-yard line of Contra Costa. Banks in the shotgun. Hands it off to 28. Holcomb. Looks like it's going to be a hold. The flag has been thrown in. So it looks like it's a gain of 3 or 4, but that gain may be negated by a hold by Contra Costa. As we wait for the penalty.
On the offense, number 58.
So it is a hold.
10 yards.
For Contra Costa. That's their second penalty of the game.
Check that. Replay. Second down.
So a second down.
Holding penalty moves the ball.
At the 36 yard line.
The
second and 19.
To the 36, rather.
So that's their second penalty of the game.
Makes it second and 19 at the 36.
So they've moved themselves back. The second and 19 with 45 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Look like it's a timeout.
Timeout. Contra Costa. Their second.
That's their second timeout in the quarter. They have one remaining.
Second timeout for Contra Costa. They
so far, in this game, you have San Jose City College, who's winning 10-7.
In the first quarter, the score shows they've scored San Jose City College 10, Contra Costa College 7.
A pass to Enick for 40 yards and a field goal
this afternoon.
Off
half-time
the turnover.
Score, Air Force 21, Nevada.
Contra Costa. The pass to Enick was a fourth
final
down
South
play.
Carolina 23, Florida
down the left
20
sideline.
Overtime.
Quarterback found him on a one-on-one coverage.
As we heard in the fourth quarter,
touchdown.
Pittsburgh 35, North Carolina 34. Third
so
quarter score, Marshall.
Second and
20,
19 at the 36-yard line of Contra Costa as they're trailing with 39 seconds left in the quarter, 10-7.
Second and 19 at the 36.
Banks comes up to center, gets in the shotgun. He has three receivers to his left, one to his right. There's a snap for Banks. Throws to the right flat. First down. No, it's not a first down. I'm sorry. It's a gain of 12. So that pass was number 80 for Contra Costa. Sterling Taylor, freshman out of Atlanta, Georgia. So it'll be third down for Contra Costa, like third and seven. Seven. 20 seconds remaining in the quarter. Third and seven, three receivers to his left, one to his right. Banks receives a snap, blitz is coming to the right side, throws it over the right side. Looks like it's a first down for Contra Costa College. That's Banks again.
Pass complete to number 80.
To number 80, Taylor. Sterling Taylor for a first down.
38-yard line and first down for Contra Costa.
So it looks as though they're going to run the clock down.
This
is going to be the end of the first quarter.
San Jose City College 10.
So at the end of the first quarter, San Jose City College is winning 10-7 over the favored Contra Costa Comets. So far, San Jose City College has done an outstanding job of keeping Contra Costa off the scoreboard. Outside of the roughing the passer penalty, which prolonged the drive for Contra Costa College, City College was commanding a great defensive effort by keeping Contra Costa out of the end zone. They're doing a lot of blitzing. They're not giving Banks enough time to sit back and read his offensive keys, but the pass that Banks made for the touchdown to McPhee in the first quarter gave them the lead at 7-3, but then City College of San Jose came right back on a fourth down, and Enick caught a 25, 30-yard touchdown up the left sideline, and that's where we're at right now with a 10-7 score for San Jose City College. And again, Contra Costa has an opportunity to wrap up the Northern Division, win the conference title, and play in the championship game against the winner of the Southern Division. So it'll be first and 10 at the 38-yard line of San Jose City College.
Second quarter, first and 10 at the 38-yard line of the Jaguars.
Banks is back in the shotgun. receives the kick. There's a snap. There's a pass down the sideline again to Sterling. Oh, it looks like it's going to be interference. It wasn't interference. Banks excluded the rush to the right on the run, makes the throw down to number 80. Looked like it could have been interference by Marseille Stewart, but officials didn't see it that way, so it was an overthrown pass for Banks, so it'll be second and 10 at the 38-yard line. Marseille Stewart has been the favorite target so far for Banks. The freshman from Berkeley, California. Banks is in the shotgun, receives a snap, throws a slant over the middle, almost intercepted by number 7. Number 7 had an opportunity. Chris Desmuke had an opportunity to walk into the end zone if he makes that catch. Goes through his hands, so to be third down. Those are the kind of plays when you're not favored to win, you got to make those plays. That would have been an excellent opportunity for San Jose City College to extend their lead, but they're giving Banks another opportunity. It's third and 10. Banks back to pass. Looks down the field, throws it over the middle. Incomplete pass to number 80. Looked like he's his favorite target so far, Sterling Taylor. So it'll be fourth and 10 at San Jose City College's 38-yard line. So far, Contra Costa was 2 for 4, 2 out of 4 for third down. So now it's a fourth and 10.
Sideline warning on the Contra Costa bench.
So Contra Costa received a sideline warning. But fourth down, currently Contra Costa is 1 for 2 in fourth down conversions. So they're at the 38-yard line of San Jose City College, down 10-7 at the 14:46 mark in the second quarter. Banks in the shotgun, receives a snap, a blitz by San Jose City. Looks like he has Banks. Banks escapes again, makes another man miss, and he's going to be tackled for a loss.
Still back at the 39.
So it'll be turnover on downs for Contra Costa as number 7, Des Mook, who missed the interception, the sure interception, put the pressure on Banks, flushed him out of the pocket, lost his helmet on the play.
First and 10 at
San Jose City College was able to corral
to 14:37 left.
Banks for a turnover on downs. So it's first and 10 on their own 39-yard line for San Jose City College. Again, they're doing a great job of not allowing Banks to sit back and pass the ball. They're putting pressure on him, making him make plays and beat them with his feet. So they've done a good job so far. As is, again, it's 10-7 right now for City College of San Jose on their own 39-yard line.
Let's go, defense. Interception, bitch.
So Prentin Paganini in the shotgun. I'm sure he's going to be looking for Enoch, since 80 in motion. Receives a snap. Throws to number 80, but it's short. Tried to hit 80 on a out pattern. So it'll be second down and 10 for an incomplete pass from Pagnini to number 80 for San Jose City College, which is Kyrie Davis. So it'll be second and 10 at the 39-yard line. City College of San Jose is winning 10-7. At the 14:34 mark in the second quarter. Pagnini receives a snap, makes the handoff. Looks like it's going to be a gain of a couple. So it's going to be third down for San Jose City College. That handoff was to Gabe Davis, a freshman running back out of San Jose, California. It'll be third and 8. For San Jose City College. So far, they're 0-for-3 for third down conversions. Here's a pass by Pagnini, throws the ball in, incomplete pass. It was intended for number 80 for
San Jose City College. Looked like he got his feet tangled up. That'd be Kyrie Davis. So it'll be fourth down for San Jose City College. So this is the second punt of the ball game for San Jose City College. So the defense for Contra Costa held up strong on that drive. So they'll be receiving the ball back deep for Contra Costa College.
Special welcome to the alumni and fans.
Number three and number nine, Jeremy Rainey and Terrence Barnes will be back. Here's the punt. It's going to be short. Looks like it's shanked to the side of his foot. It's going to be down at the 45-yard line for Contra Costa College. So City College of San Jose had a chance to pin Contra Costa deep, but the punter shanked the kick off the side of his foot. So Contra Costa is in business at the 45-yard line for Contra Costa. So Contra Costa again is down 10-7 at the 13:48 mark in the game.
Texas Tech 7, Oklahoma nothing. First quarter score, TCU
Banks has two receivers to his right, one to his left.
And a second quarter score.
And the pistol. Hands the ball off.
Notre Dame 20, Northwestern 16.
Like it's a gain of 3 or 4. For Holcomb. So it'll be second down.
Holcomb on the carry brings the ball up to about.
And 7 at the 48-yard line. It's a nice crowd at the game today on both sides. Stands are almost filled completely on both sides. Excellent senior day. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Banks receives a snap, back to pass, throws an out pass to 17, breaks the tackle, he's down. Actually got a leg tackle for number 21, but the pass was complete to number 17 for Contra Costa, Renard McPhee, and it looks as though that's going to be a first down.
For a Contra Costa first down.
So first down from Banks to McPhee. Receivers two to the left of Banks, one to the right. Holcomb the lone back. Banks receives it, hands it off to Holcomb, goes over the right side, powers down for about a gain of 5. So it's going to be 2nd and 5, and one of the things that Coach Carter mentioned earlier when we spoke was that he needed to impose his will, his team needed to impose their will on City College of San Jose from the get-go, and it's been kind of tough right now. City College of San Jose has came in this game and playing this game extremely focused and motivated. 2nd and 5 for Contra Costa at the 40-yard line of City College of San Jose. Banks checks the line. Checks out of the play. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. Receives a snap, back to pass, throws that quick out to number 17. A back shoulder pass to 17. And that'll be first down to Renard McPhee. So Banks throws a back short shoulder pass to number 17 for a first down. So now it's 1st and 10 at the 31-yard line for San Jose City College. Contra Costa down by 3, 10-7 at the 12-12 mark in the game. Sends a man in motion. Banks does. Receives a snap. Back to pass. 17 is wide open. Misses that pass. Throws it to number 6 for Contra Costa. Larry Cornish Jr. But Banks missed 17. Renard McPhee was running down the sideline and no one guarded him. So I'm sure they're going to come back to that play because he was wide open going down the right sideline, which could have been his 2nd touchdown of the game. 3 receivers to the right, one to the left. Sends number 6 Cornish in motion. Hands the ball off to Holcomb. Goes to the right side. He's out of bounds. Looks like it's a gain of 3 or 4, but a flag on the play. So it looks like it's going to be holding. It is. It's going to be holding against Contra Costa. So that's going to back them up. That'll be their 3rd penalty of the day for 30 yards.
Offense number 76.
So number 76 with the hole for Contra Costa pushes them back 10 yards. So it's going to be
that
moves the ball back to the 40-yard line.
Second and 19.
So it'll be 2nd and 19 from San Jose City College's 40-yard line. Banks in the shotgun. Receives a snap. San Jose sends a blitz up the middle. Banks stands tall, throws it over the middle. Incomplete. Knocked down by number 28 for San Jose City College. Threw in the triple coverage there. Was lucky he didn't come away with an interception on that play. John Aguari got his hand on the ball and knocked the ball down. So it'll be third down and 19 for Contra Costa College. So far, they're 2-for-4, 50% for the game. So this is a big play for Contra Costa as well as San Jose City College. They can get off the field here and get the football back. City College brings the blitz. Number 7 comes up. Banks will lose that runner. Throws the ball over the middle. It's going to be third down, but it's complete. It's complete for a gain of 12. So it'll be, it was to number 88 for Contra Costa. So Banks to number 88 for a gain of 12 to Jathan Collins. So it'll be fourth and 7 for Contra Costa College. This is an important drive. San Jose City College needs a stop to get off the field. Contra Costa has momentum right now. They're 1-for-3 on fourth down conversions so far in the first half. Banks receives a snap, looks over the middle. He's being flushed out of the pocket. He can run for it. He makes a move, and he breaks a couple of tackles, three tackles. Touchdown, touchdown, Contra Costa College on the fourth down, but there is a flag on the play
at the 9-yard line.
So it may be a hold here on Contra Costa College, but Banks, with a Superman effort, was able to break three or four tackles to get in the end zone.
Holding offense.
So it's a holding on the offense for Contra Costa. So another 10-yard penalty. So that's their fourth penalty
for
40 yards, but they were able to convert on the fourth down, so they do keep the drive alive. So the touchdown is wiped off the board, but they do keep the drive alive, and they'll have the ball at the 20-yard line of City College of San Jose. Bank, that was all Banks there. He made three or four guys miss and waltzed into the end zone. Here's a handoff to Holt from over the right side. Looks like he's going to go in untouched for the touchdown. So a power run to the right side for Holcomb for 20 yards. It's a 20-yard touchdown to Holcomb. So Contra Costa regains the lead, and depending on the extra point, they'll be up by either 4 or 3.
Harold Holcomb with the touchdown. Now they can climb inside.
So at the 10-13 mark, Holcomb runs over the right side for 20 yards for the touchdown. Fonseca with the extra point.
It's good.
So it's 14-10 at the 10-13 mark for Contra Costa. So Contra Costa was able to battle through that penalty that they had for Banks' touchdown and come back with Holcomb for a sweep to the right side for his first touchdown in the ball game. So it's 14-10 for Contra Costa College.
Scoring
going into the 10-13 point in the first in the second quarter of the game.
In the first half, the score, Contra Costa 14 and San Jose College.
So up to that point, San Jose City College did an excellent job of keeping Contra Costa out of the end zone, and a lot of it was the fact that Contra Costa hurt themselves by penalties. And we spoke about that, me and Coach Carter spoke about that earlier, about his teams getting a lot of penalties, and he wasn't happy about that. He said that he's made a lot of emphasis on in practice on the importance of not getting stupid penalties, because against really good teams, it can definitely hurt them down in the long run. So they have to do a better job with penalties and managing their penalties, but right now, they're up 14-10 against San Jose City College. So San Jose City College needs to come back and get some points, keep their defense off the field to get back in this ball game. Here's a kick by Fonseca. and they elected to kick the ball out of bounds because San Jose City College has been, their best offense has been their kickoff returns. And they had one for 55 yards and one for 40 yards earlier in the game. So to be first down for San Jose City College.
Kickoff out of bounds on the kicking team.
So it'll be a penalty on City College of Contra Costa for kicking the ball out of bounds. And so City College of San Jose will take the 5-yard penalty and will take the ball at the 35-yard line of their own 35-yard line. Tagnini is back at the snap receiver. Run! Snap, run up the middle by number 38, Shante Brewer for City College of San Jose for a gain of 7.
42.
So it'll be second down and 3 for City College of San Jose. Tagnini in the shotgun. Three receivers to his right, one to his left, receives a snap, hands the ball off again, breaks the tackle. Looks like that's going to be a first down. So that's two running plays by number 38. Shante Brewer, which results in a first down. So I'm sure that Coach Connor for San Jose City College understands that he's going to have to run the football to keep this high-powered offense for Contra Costa off the field. At the 9:30 mark in the game, Contra Costa is winning 14-10 against a game San Jose City football team right now. Three receivers to his right, one to his left. Receives a snap, looks to pass down the middle, wide open, number 80 over the middle of the field, and it'd be for a first down. So he found number 80 on a crossing route in the middle of the field for a first down. That's Kyrie Davis. So it'll be first down for San Jose City College. By far, this is their best drive of the day. Three possessions, two for runs, a first down, one for a pass over the middle, crossing route to Davis for a first down. So it's first and 10 at Contra Costa's 34-yard line at the 8:57 mark. That was a good-looking pass and a great route design by San Jose City College. Pagnini in the shotgun, three receivers to his right. The running back moves to his left. There's a timeout on the field. It's a delay of game penalty for City College of San Jose. So that'll push them back. Overall, though, that's the third penalty for San Jose for 25 yards. So it'll be first and 15 at the 39-yard line of Contra Costa College. Pagnini receives a snap, throws the ball off his back foot to the right. It was intended for number 80, Kyrie Davis. This was short. The pressure was coming up the middle from Contra Costa College, and it'll be second and 15 at the 39-yard line. So second and 15 at the 39-yard line for San Jose City College, who's down 14-10. But this drive they have, this particular drive has been their best drive of the day by completing a couple of first downs and an excellent pass to number 80, Davis. He received a snap, a slant over the middle, broken up by number 16 of Contra Costa College. Demarius Brayson breaks up the slant pass from San Jose City College. So now it's third and 15. So far today, San Jose City College is 0 for 4 on third downs. They have better success on fourth downs and third downs. So this is a third and 15 at Contra Costa's 39-yard line. Two receivers to his left, two to his right, receives a snap, looks downfield, throws it over the middle, almost intercepted by number Number 30, Contra Costa, had an easy interception there. Let the ball slip out of his hands. But it's a Chami Aniku who had an opportunity to get an interception. So it's fourth down now for San Jose City College at the 39-yard line. So I'm sure this is too far to think about a field goal. So the last time they had a fourth down, they hit Enoch for a touchdown down the left sideline. So I'm sure they're confident with that. But fourth and 15 for San Jose City College. Contra Costa may be bringing a blitz. It'll be a timeout on the field for San Jose City College. So Contra Costa has made a great stand by coming back in this game by taking the lead of 14-10. I'm sure Coach Carter isn't happy on how his team is playing right now, but they have the lead right now at 14-10, 8 minutes left in the second quarter. They get a stop here to get the ball back, and they're being in good position to take control of this football game, but San Jose City College is doing an excellent job of playing a well-coached game, both on the offensive and defensive end. Now it's fourth and 15. Again, as I mentioned, the last time they had fourth and long, they had a touchdown pass to Enoch down the left sideline. So I'm sure that's going to be a target that Pagnini is going to be looking for. That seems to be his favorite target. But number 80, Davis, had a couple of clutch catches as well on this drive. So this is a key play for Trenton Pagnini and the San Jose City College Lancers right now to see exactly what they're going to do. He has two receivers to his right, two to his left. He receives a snap, back to pass, throws the ball downfield. It's going to be deflected, incomplete pass to number two for San Jose City College. That was a Kirby Linscomb. If caught, it would have been well short of the first down. So a turnover on downs for Contra Costa College.
First and 10 at the 39 with 8:14 left in the first half. The score, Contra Costa 14, San Jose City College 10.
So Contra Costa College right now was able to get a turnover on downs, so they received the ball back 14-10 at the 8:14 mark. They're going left to right. Banks in the shotgun, three receivers to his right, motions Cornish over to the left. Hands the ball off to Holcomb, who takes it up the middle for a gain of 3 or 4. So it'll be second down and around 6 or 7.
Hands up to Holcomb, he carries the ball up to the...
One turnover today for Contra Costa College, which resulted in 3 points for San Jose City College. San Jose City College has no turnovers for today. And Coach Connor was very adamant about not turning the ball over, giving Contra Costa an opportunity to score with a short field. Second and 4 was a gain of 6 by Holcomb. At the 45-yard line of Contra Costa, Banks receives the snap, looks downfield, throw, he has number 9 wide open, and he overthrows number 9 for the fly rider. It looked like he did 4 verticals on that play call. Number 9 was broke free. That'll be Terrence Barnes. And Banks just overthrow about a half a step. He makes that catch. He walks into the end zone. It's a missed opportunity for Contra Costa. The 3rd and 4 at the 45-yard line for Contra Costa College. Banks is over center. First time today over center. San Jose plays a blitz. Looks like it's going to be an offside against San Jose City College. So it looks as though it may be an offside or a procedure waiting for the officials to make the call. But it's going to be offsides for San Jose City College.
Offside on the defense, number 99, 5 yards, results in the first down.
Offside against.
So an offside, and that's the 4th for 30 yards. That's going to result in a first down for San Jose City College. For Contra Costa. So it'll be 1st and 10 at the 50-yard line of Contra Costa as a result of that offside for San Jose City College. Banks receives a snap, looks downfield, throws the ball over the middle of the field, broken up by number 23. For San Jose City College, ball was thrown over the middle. Banks was trying to get the ball down the field over the middle, but it was broken up by a fine play by the safety. So it'll be second and 10 for Contra Costa College. So Banks tried to do a post route over the middle of the field, but number 23 did a great job of knocking the ball out of the hands of the receiver, and it'll be second and 10,
second and 10 at, the
50-yard line. Another looks like another offsides again for San Jose. So that's two penalties on this drive for 10 yards. And I'm sure the coach for San Jose isn't happy about that because they're giving yards away to Contra Costa College.
Prior to the snap, offsides.
Another offsides call. So that's two offsides calls on two on the current drive. So right now, City College has five penalties for 35 yards. Contra Costa has four penalties for 40 yards with 7:24 left in this first half. So Contra Costa is winning 14-10. Banks in the shotgun receives a snap. Fakes the screen, middle screen over the middle to number 13, receives it to the left, breaks the tackle down at the 27-yard line. So Banks, they faked the outside screen, ran a middle screen for Frank Stevens. And Stevens to Banks, that was a gain of 18 yards. So a gain of 18 yards, so it'll be first down for Contra Costa at San Jose's 27-yard line. Banks receives a snap, throws a quick out route, caught by number nine, so that's a gain of seven or eight. So Contra Costa is moving the ball down the field. That pass was complete to Terrence Barnes, a gain of eight, so a second and two at San Jose's 19-yard line, and it looks as though Contra Costa is imposing their will now. They're playing a lot faster, more confident going into the second half. The 6:38 left in the first quarter. Banks receives a snap, throws an out pass to number 17. Looks like that's going to be a first down too. So Banks to Renard McPhee for first yard. So that's a first down. Banks to McPhee, a left out route. So first and 10 at the 14-yard line for Contra Costa as they're driving down the field.
It'll be first and 10.
So it's first and 10 for Banks. Look like they have their confidence now since Cornish on the sweep, handoff inside to Holcomb. Looked like he's going to be stopped for no gain. So that was the one of the rare drive runs on this drive. They've been very successful running, passing the football. So they try to run on that particular play, and it was stopped for no gain. Actually, it was a loss of two. Number 37 for Contra Costa checks in for Holcomb, and that would be Devin Jones. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Banks receives a snap. San Jose brings a blitz, throws it over the middle. Touchdown! Touchdown! Looks like it's going to be a touchdown for Contra Costa College, as Banks threw a rifle in to Larry Cornish for a touchdown. He threw it in between three players for the touchdown for Contra Costa College. So Banks drops back and throws a laser in between three defenders for the touchdown. That puts Contra Costa up 20-10, pending the extra point by Von Seca. So excellent job there by Banks finding the open receiver. And the kick is, look like it's no good. So it'll be a missed field goal, but it's 20-10 for Contra Costa College. The 5:38 mark. Banks to Cornish for the touchdown. So Contra Costa is winning 20-10. Look like they're taking control of this game with 5:38 left in the half. That was an excellent, excellent pass by Banks. Threw that pass in between three players for the touchdown. San Jose City College helped Contra Costa on that particular drive by two penalties for 10 yards. Both of them were on offsides for both of the penalties. So looked like we're going into halftime at the 5:38 mark. We have 5:38 left to go into halftime. I'm sorry. The Comets of Contra Costa is winning 20-10. Back deep for San Jose City College is number 20 and number 38. And remember, San Jose City College started a game off with a 55-yard kickoff return. They came right back with a 42-yard kickoff return. As I mentioned earlier, their kick return is their best offense so far. They kick to number 20. He receives it in his end zone, comes out running, comes out to his left side. Again, he breaks up another tackle. Looks like it's almost a hole. So that ball, he's out at the 38-yard line. They're positive yards every time on the kickoff return. Contra Costa special teams, I'm sure they're going to address that at halftime, because City College of San Jose is getting large chunks of yards on kickoff returns. You don't want that to be your best offense. That means that the other team is scoring, but if they can use that as an offense, a weapon, that'd be great, but they need to get some stops. So it's 20-10 at the 5:32 mark. It's changed quarterbacks, and number 11's into the game with the quarterback. Looked like he threw an interception, but it was incomplete. So number 11 came in for that possession for San Jose City College. That's Ray Rivera. Marcus freshman Matthew quarterback out of San Jose, California. And his first pass was incomplete, almost a turnover for San Jose City College. They've done a good job so far but not turning the ball over. And I'm sure that Coach Connor was not happy about that pass, because that could have gave Contra Costa the ball in San Jose City College possession on their side of the field. So the freshman is back, hands the ball off. And it looks like it's a no gain. So no gain for San Jose City. Number 20 was stopped. Valenzuela for no gain. Looks like it's a loss of a couple. So I don't know what's going on with Trent Pagnini, but they made the change to Ray Rivera at quarterback. I don't know if he's injured or anything, but Rivera is now in, the freshman quarterback out of San Jose, California, Oak Grove High School. So three receivers to the right, one to the left. Rivera in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. Throws the ball, checked down. It was knocked down to the line of scrimmage by Contra Costa. So to be fourth down. So that was another third down. Missed conversion. Again, San Jose City College is 0 for 5, 0 for 6 on third downs today. And this will be their third punt.
Fourth and 12.
It's 4th and 12, and Contra Costa will receive this football with good position. His number 3 will be back to receive, which is Jeremiah Rainey. It will be a penalty, 12 men on the field for Contra Costa. So the number 9 was trying to get off the field, but he wasn't able to get off. So it will be a penalty for Contra Costa. That's their 5th penalty for today.
Illegal substitution
penalties. So that give San Jose City College 5 extra yards for the punt. So that's their 5th penalty for 45 yards today for San Jose City College. Here's the punt. Here's the rush. Barely gets it off. Here's the kick. It's going to be short. And it's going to be downed at the 35-yard line of Contra Costa. So Contra Costa
24-yard punt
will take over on downs at the 35-yard line on the punt. It'll be first and 10 at the 35, leading 20-10 with 4 minutes and 37 seconds left in the first half. No turnovers for Contra Costa today, and only one for San Jose. So in regards to a clean game, it's been pretty clean in regards to turnovers. Penalties, a little bit too many penalties, but no turnovers for today. Only one. Contra Costa back to pass. Flushed out of the pocket as Banks makes the pass to the left side. Number 9. Looks like he's going to make the catch. Got a couple of tackles. To Barnes. Well, that's a gain of 7 or 8, but it's a penalty on Contra Costa. Looks like it's going to be a hold on that. So that's going to take them back 10 yards.